Dear friends, we have tried to understand Shakespeare's Julius Caesar as one of the great tragedies. Shakespeare is known for the plot construction and very accuracy that he developed in his construction of the plot. The context or the location and the situations are very apt in his plays. Soliloquies are one of the major concepts in Shakespearean plays. In the same way, in Julius Caesar, Shakespeare has brought in the porum scene. Porum scene is the consequential scene that is most significant in the play after the murder of Julius Caesar. After murdering Julius Caesar, with the help of his conspirator friends, Brutus thinks that he has to address the citizen, and as a result of that plan, Brutus comes on the stage in the street, and this scene is called Porum scene. The third act of the play and the second scene of the third act is significant by the name Porum scene. It is the speech delivered by Brutus followed by Mark Antony. Brutus wants to justify why he should murder Julius Caesar. The need of assassinating Julius Caesar is justified in the speech. These two speeches, or this speech that is delivered by two great personalities in the play Julius Caesar, is called Porum scene, and it is very significant in deciding the future course of the play, or taking revenge on the murderers of Julius Caesar. The Porum scene plays a very significant role. In the beginning, it was Brutus who comes on the stage, on the platform, to address the people. Before coming on the stage, Brutus has made an understanding and an agreement with Mark Antony that Mark Antony will pay tribute to Julius Caesar only with the permission of Brutus, and Mark Antony's speech will not affect Brutus's words. That was the understanding between the two, and hence Mark Antony was also permitted. In the beginning, it was Brutus who comes on the stage. When Brutus appears on stage, people were very curious to know what is the need of murdering Julius Caesar. And as a systematic way and his skilled oratorial speech, Brutus begins addressing the people as the Romans, countrymen and lovers. Brutus says that he loved Caesar so much, but at the same time he loved Rome also. Not that he loved less Rome than Julius Caesar. That was Brutus's beginning speech. He tries to bring the people to his favor by addressing the people as Romans, countrymen and lovers. And he justifies his action, the murder of Caesar. Otherwise, Caesar would have grown dictator and made all the Romans as slaves. Who wants to be a slave is a question that Brutus asks, that touches the heart of people, and people admire Brutus as right in murdering Julius Caesar. Brutus highlights the idea that Caesar was ambitious and growing dictator. That is why they had to kill Julius Caesar. Entire group of conspirators think that they did such a great work. After Brutus' speech, Mark Antony comes on the stage. Brutus and Mark Antony are highly rhetorical in their speech. Mark Antony's speech is a counter speech to Brutus. Mark Antony, who comes on the stage, begins in the same way. People were very curious to know how Mark Antony will speak. Mark Antony, in the beginning, asks for the people to lend their ears to his words. He tells that he came to pay tribute to dead Caesar. But afterwards, he turns the whole mob into his favor by ironically taunting Brutus as a nobleman. But how Brutus failed to be noble, and how Caesar was not ambitious, how Caesar was not a dictator in his nature, was proved by Mark Antony's speech. Mark Antony tells that Caesar was so kind, and he made a will. He wrote all his orchard to the people and for the public use, and Caesar made in his will that each citizen will get 8 drachmas, the money for the individual's favor. Mark Antony's speech, that is how, turns upside down the whole plan of Brutus. Just as Brutus began with Romans, countrymen and lovers, Mark Antony also addressed people as Romans and the lovers of the country who must listen to his speech. He justifies how the character of Caesar was so gentle, kind and humane. Caesar, for his will that he made and his kindness, became a great humane in his nature. Caesar loved his countrymen, that is proved in his contribution he made to country, and his whole property is given to people. The sacrifice that Caesar made for the sake of people is unforgettable. That kindness of Caesar cannot be ignored. Even when Caesar was such a great, humane, kind and sympathetic towards people, how a man like Brutus can kill Caesar is a question. And Mark Antony, as he makes his speech justifying Caesar's goodness, tells that Brutus's act is the most unkindest cut of all. Mark Antony, through his statement, makes the whole mob turn against Brutus, and the people who listen to Mark Antony are ready to set fire to Brutus's house and the houses of all the conspirators like Casca, Cinna, Cassius, Trebonius, etc. People are raged, and Mark Antony succeeds in kindling the fire of anger and hatredness of citizen towards Brutus. Brutus's whole idea of winning the favor of citizen, justifying the murder of Caesar, utterly fails. Mark Antony, who was a close hand, like a right hand of Caesar, tries to serve Caesar and pay a tribute by making the people wage a war against Brutus, and he succeeds in turning the whole wave of the emotion of people and the love for Caesar that is not dead. With the death of Caesar is proved by Mark Antony's speech. Antony succeeds in saying that Caesar was never ambitious. Instead of that, Caesar was kind, sympathetic and genuine, humane in helping the people and serving his country. The patriotism of Caesar could not be questioned. It was beyond the doubt of people. Thank you.